एवरीवन, वेलकम टू टेस्का टेक्नोलॉजीज प्राइवेट लिमिटेड। माय नेम इज आशिम दत्ता एंड टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट टेट्रॉड कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स एंड इट्स ऑर्डर कोड इज 36162। सो इन दिस वीडियो वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट इट्स बॉडी पार्ट्स एंड इट्स वर्किंग। नाउ लेट्स टॉक अबाउट द बॉडी पार्ट्स ऑफ दिस किट। सो दिस इज द वोल्ट मीटर। फ्रॉम हेयर वी विल मेजर ग्रीड बायस वोल्टेज। देन दिस इज द वोल्ट मीटर एंड करंट मीटर। फ्रॉम हेयर वी विल मेजर स्क्रीन वोल्टेज एंड स्क्रीन करंट। देन दिस इज अनादर वोल्ट मीटर। फ्रॉम हेयर वी विल मेजर प्लेट वोल्टेज। देन दिस इज अनादर करंट मीटर। फ्रॉम हेयर वी विल मेजर प्लेट करंट। देन दिस इज द वोल्टेज एंड करंट स्विच। वैन वी कीप द स्विच एट वोल्टेज पोजिशन वी कैन मेजर द वोल्टेज फ्रॉम दिस मीटर। वैन वी कीप द स्विच एट करंट पोजिशन एट दैट टाइम वी कैन मेजर द करंट फ्रॉम दिस मीटर। Then this is the grid bias voltage variable port. From here we can vary the voltage from 0 to 5 volt. Then this is the screen volt variable port. From here we can vary the voltage from 0 to 100 volt. Then this is the valve filament. This is the filament supply. Then this is the plate voltage variable port. From here we can vary the voltage from 0 to 250 volt. Then this is the main power on off button. So that's all the body parts of this kit. Now let's talk about the working of this kit. So for that we have to perform an experiment, that is to draw the characteristics of the given tetrode. So firstly we have to do the connections. So firstly we will connect the mains cord to the kit, then we will connect the grid bias positive port with the grid bias variable positive port. Then we will connect the negative port of the grid bias with the negative port of the grid bias variable port, like this. Then we will connect the positive port of screen volt current meter with the screen volt positive variable port, like this. Then we will connect the negative port of the screen volt current meter with the negative port of the screen volt variable port, like this. Then we will connect the negative port of the variable grid bias voltage with the second port of the filament. Then we will connect the positive port of the grid bias voltage with the negative port of the screen voltage. Then we will connect the negative port of the screen volt with the third port of the filament. Then we will connect the fourth port of the filament with the filament supply. Then we will connect the fifth port of the filament with the filament supply. Then we will connect the seventh port of the filament with the negative port of the plate current. Then we will connect the positive port of the plate volt with the positive port of the plate current. Then we will connect the negative port of the plate volt with the negative port of the plate volt variable port, like this. Then we will connect the positive port of the plate volt with the positive port of the plate current. Then we will connect the third port of the filament with the negative port of the plate volt variable port, like this. So that is how the connection is done. Now after the connection is done, we will switch on the power supply. Then we will check the characteristics of the tetrode. So for that we will first switch this key to the voltage, like this. Then this meter will shows voltage reading. So we will set the screen volt with this screen volt variable port. So we will set it to 80 by using this port. So here you can see that the screen voltage is at 80. Now we will keep the switch at current. Now we will give grid bias voltage from this variable port, and we can see the voltage here. So we will give 1 volt like this. So you can use this grid bias voltage variable port to give 1 volt to this grid bias. Now we will give plate voltage to 100 by using this port, and you can see the plate voltage in this meter. So set it to 100 . So after setting it to 100, you can see that this plate voltage will reduce to 50. So when you set this plate voltage 100 by using this variable port, you can see that the plate voltage drops to 50, and that shows the characteristics of tetrode. Now after this we will perform the experiment. So we will turn on the variable ports to its zero position. After that we will again give grid bias voltage at 2 volt. Earlier we have given 1 volt, now we will give it to 2 volt. So set it at 2 volt like this. So you can set the grid bias voltage from this variable port, and you can see the voltage from this grid bias voltage meter. So set it at 2 volt, then set the plate voltage by using this variable port and keep it at 50 like this. Now switch the voltage current switch at current position, because now we will measure the screen current. So now we will adjust the screen current using this port. So set it at 1 and set the plate voltage again at 50. So now you can take the readings. For grid bias it is at 2, and the screen current it is at 1, and the plate voltage it is at 50 volt, and the plate current is at 0.3 milliampere approximately. Now we will take the second reading by keeping the grid bias voltage constant. Keep it at 2 volt and take 2-3 readings. Then after we will increase the grid bias voltage in a step of 1 volt. So now we will take another reading at 2 volt grid bias. So we will increase the current. So now we will measure the plate voltage and plate current at screen current 1.5. So when we give the screen current 1.5 milliampere, we can see that the plate voltage reduces, and it is approx 20 volt, and the plate current increases, it is approximately 1 milliampere. Then again take another reading by keeping the grid bias voltage at 2 volt, and now we will give screen current 2 milliampere. So now you can see that the plate voltage reduces to 0 volt and the plate current increases to 1.2 milliampere approximately. So that is how you can take the readings. Now we will take the reading at 3 volt. So give grid bias voltage at 3 volt. We have increased the grid bias voltage in one step, like we have increased the voltage at 1 volt. So earlier it was 2 volt and now it is at 3 volt. Then we will again set the screen current at 1 milliampere. So here you can see that the plate voltage again gives approximately 52 volt, and the plate current shows current approximately 0.2 milliampere. Now we will take another reading by adjusting the screen current to 1.5. So now when the screen current is 1.5, the plate volt reduces to 35 volt approximately, and the plate current becomes 0.3 milliampere. Now we will increase the screen current to 2. So here you can see that the plate voltage reduces to 10 volt and the plate current increases and it becomes approximately 1 milliampere. So that is how you can take the readings at 2 volt and 3 volt, and you can take it for 4 volt and 5 volt also, because we can set the grid bias as 4 and 5 volt. So that is how you can take the readings, and you can plot the graph between plate voltage and screen current and plate voltage and plate current. So that is how this experiment is performed. So that's all the demonstration from my side. If you have any query related to this kit, you can contact the Tesca Global website. You can find the link in the description. For more information, go through the manual. Thank you for watching this video. If you like this video, like, share and subscribe to our channel.